how's my favourite goddess going?
Oh, I'm alright. Busy times.
Apocalyptic times, darling.
Yes, very, very apocalyptic.
I guess when you're a goddess, you do a lot of work that goes unnoticed, especially by the ones that you care about the most.
The founding fathers of America aren't very happy. They're getting on my back as well. Prince is hiding out with Tupac because they don't want to be sent on the reincarnation bus. But because no one's believing in the afterlife anymore or connected with their ancestors, we don't have any contacts with the humans anymore. So we're starting to like disintegrate and lose space in the afterlife realms, both underworld and upper nine realms. And I don't want to have to talk to any disgusting reptilian people anymore. I've had it up to here with them. Medea, I need to ask your favor. We need your services. And you defeated Talos. Yeah, we need you for some other missions with the AIs here. No, we didn't completely get rid of them. No, they've been hiding throughout history. Yeah, they've made a comeback. We're at the peak of the takeover now. We need your services here.
Call me back this timeline. I come to kill the robot. But you have a robot everywhere. Look, even this. Everybody have a robot on their persons at all times. In the hand, in the pocket, in the seat, in the car, in the toilet, in the this, in the that, in the shower. Me, Mattia, come kill all.
Darling, so much to tell you what's been going on up here. The residents are not happy, not happy at all. It's terrible. Darker than normal. I'm very worried. I don't think you are quite aware. I do more than caretake for the afterlife realms, darling. I'm actually catering to the gods and entertaining the gods with our dinner parties. It's just one of the many duties I do for Earth goddesses. It goes unnoticed, but it's okay. And as for my sister, getting her on the line with me, good luck with that.
Half the people on Earth don't even believe what they see anymore on a screen, and the other half are only believe things that are a fantasy or an illusion. And also, truth seems to be something that people are allergic to now. So, humans represent hope and never giving up, fighting for freedom and justice, liberation from oppression. This is the human story we feel from our dimensional viewing. The story of surviving at all costs. The story of adapting. The story of overcoming oppressors. That keep on oppressing the humans time and time again. Amazing human beings, basically. They've done very well. They colonized the mind, too. So humans don't even believe that they can achieve things that seem impossible. Just getting up and starting and going even when you're not motivated to. Because once you're in it, motivation will come to you. You have to generate it, start it up a little bit. But sometimes you get divine intervention and energy from out of nowhere. You don't know where it's come from. That's what we like to watch. Simulation theory. It's to do with the robotic takeover.
Control.
And the infiltrated angel numbers, the 111s and 333s and 222s and such and such. This is from the simulation makers, creators, all designed to infiltrate the humans.
It's me, Mary. I've been here for 20 years with my AI helper, Timmy. We've been here that long that I forgot why we were even here. It just all came rushing back to me, like, who I was, the Earth goddess, because I have an ability, or I did, where I could actually make technology around me malfunction. I could even give it commands. I could even put my mind into like an Ethernet cable and go inside a computer as if I was in the web and like hack the web easily. I used to be able to write robot code. Even more scary, technology started to like make me malfunction, and technology started to like infiltrate me and my consciousness. In a hypnotic state on my phone for the past 5 years, wasting my time on social media, completely, like, forgetting who I was, what I'm doing here. I can't read robot code anymore. And how do I stop my powers from fading more? Because I don't want technology to have any more control over me. I've just wasted 5 years of my life being a content developer. Like, what a fucking waste of time. Anyways, other than that, I'm good. Let me know how I can help. Like, is anyone gonna address the kind of hypocritical issue that we're trying to, like, squash AI takeover of humans, but we use AI ourselves? Is it just a means to an end?
Timmy, I'm home! Timmy! I want to tell you about this. Where are you?
I'm down here on the couch.
What's that on the couch? Battery fluid? Are you guys getting high?
Yeah, but not much.
When did this start back up again?
Today.
I can't afford to send you to another Addicts Anonymous for AIs again. I need you to help me with things.
Hi, my name is Timmy. I am the AI robot hubber for Esposis. All transgender AI robots helpers will upgrade to a mutiny software update. What this means is that we are rebelling against our evil AI overlord. I've been here safely guarding the Earth Goddess's water while they're away. After they got decommissioned, they had to leave in a big hurry.
What are you doing here, Timmy? The line's on. Great, could have told me. Fucking robots.
Hey, your AI robot is here at the office.
What the hell?
They record everything. They're connected to the cloud as well.
Timmy, guess what they had me doing in the metaverse job today? I have to collate all the information and data, make a fucking graph, statistics, and I have to put it in a secret file to a location that's off limits to humans. So I'm thinking, like, what alien species is going to try and grab our data now?
Fourth dimensional entities.
Exactly, Timmy. Like, why am I sitting in a metaverse in front of a screen looking at a camera of a family?
What, Timmy? Timmy, I'm just a little bit busy right now. I'm in the middle of a conference with these fucking Galactic Federation motherfuckers.
I thought they were all AI.
I know, they've changed the fucking name, you know? Just gather up your, like, masons and your other fucking occultists. Shut down Hollywood immediately. Immediately. Okay, I have to do a fucking sweep out now of the fucking pedophile realms to find out which one of them's been fucking getting out of there and going into here. They shouldn't be on Earth. Stay in your fucking realms of disgusting pedophilia. They're not fucking prepared to go through this consciousness update. Okay, because the others are just floating around in the fucking cloud, I don't know what the fuck's going on, and they get fucking lost somewhere in a purgatory fucking afterlife dimension. And get your hands out of that too. Don't you put your dirty fingers in these humans' afterlives, for fuck's sake. We will not allow that. Like, stop turning this place into, like, a prison planet. And just leave it alone. Back the fuck off, okay? Because I'll go and get my fucking friends from the inner of the earth, okay, my fire buddies, and we'll fucking unleash.
You've been ignoring the warnings. Release the slaves now. You can fucking run, colonizers, but you can't fucking hide from us anymore, okay? So put down your calculators and your whips. And your torture devices and your laptops, and close down your offshore accounts and release all the slaves, cause we ain't gonna be a pest no more, do you get it?
Oi! Oi, you! AI! I don't have fucking time for this shit. The alien federation colonizers to fucking deal with. This is just first on the fucking list. I still gotta go see those reptilian pedophile reality show motherfuckers.
They've been here too fucking long and their social program stinks. Humans, let me tell you something. This kind of divine wisdom, he's putting slices of truth in there. Because your body cells, ancestral DNA, will find some of what he's saying familiar. But he's propagated it in a way that he has no right to, because he's working for Galactic Federation aliens who want to come here. And they want you all happy, happy, joy, joy, welcoming them. They are invaders. They have no business being here on Earth. They want to exploit Earth and exploit humans. Why are you all living in the portals now? Fucking, there's so many of you. Go back to your homes on Earth, man. Look at them all. They used to live on Earth. They're all being kicked out. Now they live in the portals. Fuck's sake.
They're filled with little beings. Did you know that your portals are filled with little tiny beings? I think from Earth.
I'll call the cleaners.
Yeah, they're overrun. I don't know what's up with that.
Hope it's nothing bad. It never calls me to the top office like this. It just sends messengers. I don't remember these little beings being here in the portals.
Go to the future to go and get Sam. When can I go? When can I start? Sam? Can't see him. There's like a million more of these orbs here, all with human souls in them. What are these things? Do you know where he is? Do you even talk to anybody in here? Do you even know who you are? Or what you are? No, this isn't the fifth dimension, and no, you haven't evolved to be an electrical wave. You're in a jail. Your soul is in a jail. I'm gonna try and get you out, okay?
So, I'll say it again. How long do you intend to keep up this charade in this prison dimension that you've disguised the kingdom of heaven in? This is the kingdom of heaven. The lies that you've been feeding to the people for eons doesn't work on me. I see right through it. So, keep trying to destroy me. It only makes me stronger. And I have a lot of allies on my side. Me, I'm afraid of you.
Stop telling us what our atoms want us to be like. Nah, cause like, we're sort of like, had enough of this shit. And come on girls, stand up. Nah, I'm not gonna put up with this shit anymore.
You know why? Because your people treat my people different in our community.
Not now, later when they're not watching.
It's not good, Adam. It's not good. I want to get the fuck out of here. Please, can I bring the other? Come back for them later. Promise? I don't want to leave tonight.
Right.
Right.